So this here is an LG fridge. I'm going to be replacing all the water lines because I don't know if you can tell here. Let's see if I can get this to autofocus on here. So you can see that line right there where it's cracked. Let's see if I can get it to focus. So we're going to be replacing that hose that comes up here to the water filter, where we'll be placing those lines that go up there. That's the front line that goes to the actual front door. All those lines continue down here. They go back into the main valve separator that we're gonna open up and clean out there. Got our line here that comes back from our reverse osmosis water filtration system. So open up that vent, disconnect the valve, disconnect all these tubes, replace them. They're 1/4 inch and then 5/16 inch. It's all the FDA approved food grade standard. So that front one comes out here. So there's the door. So that's the one end of it. And that all cycles through right into there and comes out that side. So we're gonna replace all that. The water actually was starting to taste a little weird. I've replaced the filters and everything, but I think the tubes might have just got some flavor into them. So I'm hoping this replaces it all. But we'll see how it goes. I'll keep you updated as we start opening it up. Okay, we're going to test the water and see how it's squirting out. Ready? 1, 2, 3, push it down. Oh, hey, that's good. That's good. That's good. Okay, we've taken out some of the screws here. So you got one down at the bottom corner, one up there. We had one here that had a plastic cover over the top. Coming across there, one there, another one there. Got the corners, and that's all the ones, and now this will just start sliding off over the top once I move this cable all the way. So you want to make sure the it's unplugged, so I'm going to go ahead and unplug it now before I get inside there, and the water line has been shut off as well. I have a towel ready to clean up the mess. So the easiest way to disconnect these are to put this end over here and smash it down. It's easier with one hand or two hands, but then as you press that down and push it in, it'll just slide out that end real nicely. Okay, we're gonna have to take this screw off here, but first of all, I'm gonna go ahead and try to clean this up a little bit here so it doesn't contaminate anything. Okay, this is what it looks like when it comes out. So you have the main water line coming in here that's actually already filtered water too. Comes in to this valve control unit. Then this valve goes up to the actual water filter itself, which just continues to run all the way up to that top section. And then once that one comes back down, it brings this skinny line that you see right here, and that one comes into this secondary valve here. Then it splits off to the front water ice maker and then just the front water section. So those are the 1/4 inch ones coming off there. I actually got the 5/16 on one of them and 1/4 inch on the other, but the 1/4 inch return from the main. So plan is replacing all those, putting these valves back, or these metal bands back on to protect the curves. Only two of them have it on, and then we'll squeeze them all back in there, try to tape up all these edges, make sure they're clear and or not sharp and aren't gonna damage everything. So try to dust it off. Some of this stuff just doesn't really want to come off too easily. So cleaned it off pretty well. I'll probably work on it a little bit more. Okay, the other thing I wanted to show on these is they have these little plastic kind of clips that keep them in place. So once you pry those off, which doesn't take much effort, like so, then we can just slide this up here, and then the water's probably gonna come out. So I'm gonna try to block it with my thumb here, and I'm gonna get the towel out or a bowl to catch it. Okay, I disconnected everything besides the one freezer line. I'm leaving that one on there. That one didn't have any issues. The other ones I'm gonna go ahead and fully replace since I have all the tubing for. So I came up here, took the cover off that goes to the water filter. I disconnected the line that goes to the front door. So now I'm gonna open up the fridge and disconnect the water filter, and then we're gonna start pulling these lines out and replacing them. Okay, so we've opened the fridge up, we've taken the water filter out. You can kind of see the water lines back there behind it. We're gonna try to get to that now and disconnect those. Okay, so what was holding it on here is one screw that goes right up to the top there. So we pulled that screw out, and now we're able to just, as you can see, that part just slides right off. So then you just have to grab this and pull it towards you and it'll slide off that piece. Now it gives us access to those two holes. We can pull it through and adjust. As you can see on here, it's the same type of clips on this side. We'll pop those clips off and pull the hoses out. So this here is a nice little tool. So basically you put that on here where you want it. Normally you do it with two hands. And you just press down. And then it cuts it right where you want it. Very nice. Okay, as you can tell, I've fed those lines back up through there. And now I'm gonna go connect them back on the other side. Okay, we have both lines reinstalled with the clips back in place. Make sure they're all the way seated flush in there. The bigger line was a little bit harder to get in, but now it's in. Okay, so right now I'm holding the line that I just pulled out of this door. So the way this started was this hinge was over the top here, and it had one screw that goes into that top of the cover. You pop the cover off, and you can see one of the lines goes straight down the door. The other one goes down this side right there. So I was able to pull both those out, and I'm going to try to run the other one through there. Okay, I now have the replacement quarter inch coming through. So I have all the extra up there, and so now I have it fed back through both those lines, one coming up to the top of the fridge and the one coming out the door, and then I'm gonna bind that all up and put it back in the closed spot. So now I just need to come up here and take that back off and feed it through. As you can see here, now we have the red one come up. We put the spring protector back over. Now we'll finish pushing it down there and get it down there nice so each edge is protected. And push the button so it stops blinking or beeping. And that should take us back around to the back. And there it is. Now we're gonna connect it down to the bottom line. Okay, so we reconnected all the lines. Installed the brackets to hold them in place. Came down here, had the springs on the ones that had it, reconnected them all to the valves. I'm gonna try to fit it back in there and screw it all into place and see if it has any leaks. Okay, I got all the hoses hooked up, got it turned on at the moment. I was just pressing the button to see if anything's leaking. Earlier I had a leak on one of the blue lines. I actually had it a couple of inches too short and it was making it too tight down there at the bottom. So now they're a little bit longer, so it won't leak, but now it's gonna be a little bit tough to close everything up. But got all the brackets back on. It's closed up all the way up to the top. So now we're just gonna go ahead and, right now I'm adding some tape on this edge to try to help prevent it. It had some padding, but I don't want it to get those, the aluminum there is really sharp. I don't want to cut right back open and start over again. So we'll see how it goes. I'm gonna shut it back off and see if I can get it closed up. Okay, we got everything sealed up now. Closed back up. All the lines are connected. All the way back up to the top. It's been tested, it's working. There was a few leaks that I had to adjust with that blue line. Overall though, not too bad.